Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining VXLAN spine and leaf architecture. Now, if you like my content so far and you're interested in seeing more networking and telecom technologies simply explained, then please subscribe now to the channel. And when you do subscribe, make sure to enable notifications like so that you'll be informed of new content. If you like this video, make sure to click that thumbs up button. Now, if you're studying VXLAN, some terminology that you will surely come across is the spine and leaf architecture. Now, so far in the VXLAN series of videos, the network topologies we've been working with have involved two VTEPs. But a typical VXLAN topology is by no means confined to just two devices. On the contrary, a data center or cloud infrastructure will typically have hundreds or even thousands of switches. A more appropriate representation of what you would have looks like this. You'll have your VTEPs on the network like so, and these are connected to each other over the underlay network. Each of these VTEPs have one or more VNIs configured on each one, and this way you can have hundreds of thousands or even literally millions of layer 2 network segments spanning tens of thousands of switches. Now, this underlay network, as we have mentioned in previous videos, can essentially be anything. It can be the internet, it can be an internal network, it can be an SD-WAN topology, it can be a series of WAN links, or any combination of these. The only prerequisite is that there is layer 3 connectivity between the VTEPs so that they can find each other and create the VXLAN encapsulations from one VTEP to another, thus creating layer 2 network segments that can span the whole topology. Now, in a data center or a cloud infrastructure, this underlay network is not typically made up of the internet or any type of WAN link. It can be, but it's not. It is most often a high-performance, high-capacity network that's typically owned by the same entity that owns the VTEPs. So if this is a cloud provider like AWS or Microsoft, all of this network will be designed and deployed by the provider. If it's within Google's data center, for example, this underlay network will have been developed and deployed and would be owned by Google itself. This is because, especially in cloud providers and data centers, you will want high-performance, high-availability networks to support these services. And cloud companies and data centers will have the facilities to support such extensive network infrastructure. So in such a case, if we could be able to take a look inside this cloud, then we'd see something like this. Here we have a series of devices which essentially make up the internal fabric of the underlay network. Now, these internal devices can be routers, but within data centers and cloud infrastructures, the devices we'd most often come across are high-performance layer 3 switches. Now, it is in such a network topology that we would call the switches in the underlay network spine switches, and our VTEPs, which are on the edge of the network, we would call leaf switches. Now, this spine and leaf terminology should not be confused with a data center spine and leaf architecture, which is a related concept, but it serves a different purpose. A data center spine and leaf architecture looks like this. Here we have the spine switches, which act as a backbone to the topology, and these are the leaf switches. These are the switches to which servers and other devices in the network connect. Each leaf switch connects to each spine switch, creating a full mesh topology between spine and leaf devices. This has several advantages, including scalability, low latency between servers, redundancy, and resilience. It essentially optimizes what we call east-west traffic, that is, traffic that takes place between the servers. Now, all of this, as we mentioned before, should not be confused with the spine and leaf terminology that's used for VXLAN. The terms spine and leaf are used more loosely to simply refer to the role devices play in the topology. Those that are on the edge of the VXLAN topology, that is the VTEPs, are called leaves, And those devices that comprise the high-capacity underlay network are called the spine devices. Now, thinking about this topology here, it gives us the opportunity to visualize a VXLAN topology logically as one big switch, with countless access ports that each belong to a VNI. From this point of view, of the connected hosts, it's like a big black box where the internal operations of how those layer 2 segments are spanned across the infrastructure are completely abstracted. So that's the gist of the spine and leaf terminology when it comes to VXLAN. The leaves are the VTEPs to which end devices such as servers connect to, and these are configured throughout the facilities of the cloud provider or of the data center, and the spine, which is all of the internal infrastructure that interconnects those leaves. Well, I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below, and please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at telecomTech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.